गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज आई हैव प्रोमिस्ड यू अ फ्यू डेज बैक, आई एम हियर टूडे विद द वॉइस चेंज एंड द नरेशन चेंज ऑफ इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस. नाउ आई हैव ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंटेड बोथ ऑफ दिस इन माई प्रीवियस यूट्यूब वीडियोज, बट एज आई टोल्ड यू दिस वीडियोज एम एट मेकिंग दिस टॉपिक इजियर टू ग्रास्प फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स. Now, whenever you are attempting to change the voice or narration of interrogative sentences, you are getting puzzled. The reason behind this is that you are not approaching it mathematically. Now, you should understand that grammar is partly or rather mostly mathematics. So, if you follow a mathematical approach, then this portion is going to be much easier for you to solve. So, in this video, the first video, I will be taking up the narration change of interrogative sentences. In the following video, I will be doing with you the voice change of interrogative sentences. So to start with, number one, when you are doing the narration change of interrogative sentences, A said to B, let's assume a sentence, will you have dinner tonight? So I'll be taking these two friends A and B. So A said to B, comma, open inverted comma, will you have dinner tonight? So first you ask yourself, how will B answer this question? Will you have dinner tonight? He will either say yes or he will say no. So you have to judge whether the answer given by the listener is going to be in yes or no, or is it going to be an elaborate detailed answer with facts and details. If the answer is in yes or no, then the change will be in this way. A asked B. This is the fundamental foundation of any indirect speech of interrogative sentence, A asked B. Then if you see that the question asked by the speaker demands the answer from the listener only in yes or no, you are going to put if or whether after A asked B. Now I will suggest don't go for whether, because whether can create a problem with the spelling in case of the weak students. By weak I don't mean the bad students. Please don't categorize yourself into good and bad, that's not the thing. But in the examination hall we often tend to make very common mistakes, or rather very common spellings go astray. So the best method will be to go for if. So A asked B, if, then the subject, he would have dinner that night. Now, when it was a question, will you have dinner tonight? If you change it to a normal sentence, statement sentence, it will be he will have dinner tonight. So, will you have, in the question sentence, I have already told you, the norm is that it is a breakup between two friends. And who does this breakup? Who is this person who comes and breaks the trust in the friendship? The subject. So will and have, these two friends, this strong bond, it is broken by, it is disrupted by the interruption of the subject. But the moment it comes back to statement sentence, again the bond is revived, because the subject is thrown out and the trust is rebuilt. So we say A asked B, if he would have. So he, the subject, comes out and the verb comes together again. It will not be if would he have, don't make this blunder, if he would have dinner that night. Now if I say will you go out with me, then what will you say? A asked B, if he would go out with A. Why? Because will you go out with me, this kind of a question demands the answer in a simple yes or no. On the contrary, if I tell you, what do you want to have for dinner tonight? A said to B, what do you want to have for dinner tonight? So if I ask you a question like this, you are not going to answer in yes or no. You will either say I want to have chapati and curry, or you will say I want to have rice and fish, or whatever, I just want to have salad. So whatever you want to have, the answer will not be in yes or no. This is the basic funda that you need to grasp. The answer will be in facts and details, as I told you. So in this case, what will be our answer? A asked B, then the question word, instead of the if or whether, the question word, what he would have for dinner that night, the same thing. Now if I tell you, where do you want to go for vacation? A asked B, where do you want to go for vacation? So here the answer will not be yes or no. It will be simply in Digha, Puri or say the temple nearby considering the lockdown situation. So A asked B, where, the question word. Now what was the question? Where do you want? So do plus want, that is the verb. Do plus want, that implies present tense. And we have seen in the laws of narration change, present tense changes to past tense. So where he wanted to go for vacation, right? So if I say, how did you break the cup? So A asked B, how? Now see, did break, how did you break? So did plus break, it implies what? Past tense, that is broke. So I have told you in the laws of narration change, past tense will be converted to past perfect. So how he had broken the cup. Now if I tell you, how are you doing nowadays? Tumi kemon acho ajkal? We asked this, na? So in that case, A asked B, how he, now how are you doing? So are doing, that is the verb. I have told you the bond between the two parts of the verb has been broken or disrupted by the interruption of the subject. The moment it comes back to a full stop or assertive sentence, its trust will be rebuilt and the bond will be revived. So how he, are doing present continuous will change to, I have already given you in the law in a previous video, past continuous. How he was doing nowadays. But if I tell you, did you see my purse? So you will say either yes or no. No elaborate answer. So A asked B, if, did you see? Did plus C implies saw. So saw is the past tense. So when changed, it will gain the form of past perfect. So A asked B, if B had seen A's purse. So you will replace A with the gender, his or her. Right? Now if I tell you, were you swimming yesterday evening? So what will I say? You will answer in yes or no. Were you swimming? So you are not going to say I was swimming in a red suit. You are only going to say yes or no. So A asked B, if, put if, because the answer of the question is in yes or no. So if B, now were swimming. Were you swimming? So were swimming, past continuous. I have already given you in the law, past continuous changes to past perfect continuous. So A asked B, if B had been swimming the previous evening. Yesterday changes to the evening before or the previous evening. So I hope this portion is clear to you. Whenever a question is asked, your first duty will be to assess whether the answer of the question can be obtained in yes or no. If it can be obtained in yes or no, then you are going to provide the answer with if. If the answer demands a data or a fact, then you are going to put the question word. So A asked B, either if or the question word. After that you put the subject, he, Ram, Sam, she, whatever. Then you put the verb together. Simple present will become simple past. Past will become past perfect. Present continuous will become past continuous. And past continuous will become present perfect continuous. Can will become could. Will become would. Shall will become should. May will become might. After that you put the rest of the sentence. This is the basic mathematical formula of changing the narration of interrogative sentences. Now, how will you understand in what form the verb is? I will just recapitulate very fast. Did you see my parts? So did plus see, that is saw, so it is past tense. Don't get confused. Don't think the verb is see. Did plus see, they have been departed. They have been estranged, separated by this trust breaking third person, you. So did see. If I tell you, do you like mangoes? So do plus like, present tense. The changed form will be simple past. A asked B, if B liked mangoes. Have you seen my pet dog? So A asked B, if he had seen. So have seen is the verb. If I tell you, had you been to London? So A asked B, if he had been. Past perfect remains past perfect. Had been to London. So in this way, you are going to identify the tense and you are going to change it accordingly by bringing them, clustering them together. Do not forget to cluster the two separated portions together in the answer of the narration change. If you keep them separated as given in the question, you are going to get a big rasagolla free of cost. You don't need to go to Kamdhenu. You will just get it free of cost. I don't think you will be opting for a free of cost rasagolla, at least in this method. So don't do this mistake. Whenever you get a question sentence, the verb will be separated. You have to bring them together in the statement sentence or the answer. That is your main work. Apart from that, you have to understand whether it will be the question word or it will be if or whether. Don't go for whether, whether it will be if. How to understand? If the question asked has an answer in yes or no, it will be if. If the question asked demands an answer in details and fact, in the answer you are going to put the question word itself. No if will be there. Understood? So what is the formula? A asked B plus, this portion is common, plus if or the question word. That is one set, segment. Segment B plus subject, the subject in the question, plus the verb together. Do you like, do plus like, it will change to don't write did like. It is a statement sentence. So they are again forming the couple, liked. Maybe there it is, did you see, don't write here had seen. Don't write in that way that did you see, maybe you write here did see. No, did you see means you are given saw. So you change it to had seen. Had seen. Okay, so in this way cluster the verb plus rest of the sentence, full stop. Then you put a full stop. So I hope it is clear to you how to change the narration of interrogative sentences. Thank you. In the next video I will be doing the narration change, the voice change of interrogative sentences. If you have any doubt, do not hesitate to drop in the comment box. Until then, take care and stay safe.